Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I did have on the agenda that we were getting a presentation by Good Energy. Apparently that's July, not June.
July 15th.
So we can cross that one off. So privilege of the floor. Debbie?
Deb Russ, and I live in Fort Jackson. I address the board tonight with total disgust and disappointment with the action and inaction taken as of late to make this a viable and fiscally responsible town. Town of Hopkinton board members and their lack of backbone to push back on efforts of the concerned citizens, mostly residents and Parrishville residents, to thwart the wind tower project. The wind company was never given a chance to speak to the town board and present the project. The fiscal irresponsible of the town board and its members is unspeakable. This project could have saved the town, a soon-to-be defunct town. The county divvying this up into parcels for the towns of Parrishville, Lawrence, and Stockton possibly be a reality. For many years, this town has rejected zoning and planning laws to allow its citizens to do what they want with their property. And in many cases, it shows in the pristine property some of the concerned citizens have such property. I see many beautiful homes, but I also see many properties that are just barely standing. The fact that you allowed a handful of non-residents to dictate what happens in this town is appalling. You have totally ignored the requests of the residents over 250 postcards. While I acknowledge a select few dedicated people have shown physical presence of support, those willing to weather the verbal abuse, the town population has basically left the town board and outsiders to see fit to the welfare of the town. We live in a community that consists of senior citizens on fixed incomes, citizens with low-paying jobs, and people on public assistance. Most of our youth have moved away or traveled great distances every week to work in higher-paying jobs to keep above the poverty level. My family has lived in this town for over 150 years, have served the community in many ways, town council, historical society, Summerfest committee, to name a few. They certainly would be disappointed to see what has happened here of late. Our town should not have to answer to communities that do not have our interest at heart. Many of the faces that have been present in the last few months were never around when volunteers were needed for various activities. Only for the handouts were they ever present. I attended board meetings before the wind project was even a thought, and no one that has attended the meeting of late ever attended or had a concern for our welfare. I also blame the people of the town for not attending the meetings and speaking up to voice their opinion. You voted for these board members to represent you, and you have not done your due diligence. A select few of the landowners have attended these meetings, taking threats from the concerned citizens, but still attended every board meeting. It is shameful that the town has not rallied behind the project because of their complacency, thinking that the state will step in and the project will be approved. Not so. Who wins? Should there be a winner? What economic assistance is going to be forthcoming to the town in balancing their budget for the next 30 years? Will it be status quo for the town board to vote once again to raise the taxes on the citizens with no real economic development in sight? Will the out-of-towners be paid and pay our taxes when they are due?
Thank you. Any other?
I would like to inform the board that the wind law number one was in effect during the time that the Avangrid was invited for Wind Bright.
Okay, thank you.
And they were invited in 2010 by previous supervisors of the town, Mr. Russ and Steve Borick, and even yourself, Madam Chairman, was interested in having a meeting a while back. And we were working under Wing Law Number 1 for approximately 7 years. It was adopted in 2011. And now we've got Wing Law Number 2, which supersedes Wing Law Number 1. But it only supersedes Wing Law Number 1 by the effective date signed in by the Secretary of State. So actually, we are going to have to abide by Wing Law Number 1, because according to Article 1, Section 10 of the United States Constitution, and Article 9 and 10 of the New York State Constitution, you cannot impede or prohibit a land use contract by a factual law. And if you try to go in and continue, your only excuse would be for health reasons to use Wing Law Number 2. 99.9% of the case law across the nation favors the contract holders. My second point is, I don't understand why the board hasn't hired an outside consultant, independent from Avangrid or ourselves, an expert in engineering acoustics and wind tower engineering, so we can get the actual scientific information that is needed for you folks to make your decisions. Now, we all have a vested interest in the proposals made by Avangrid, the fire department, the town, the leaseholders, the good neighbors, and all the rest of our residents on the 75% payment on the electric bill at the $1,200. We all have a vested interest in this. Every residential town member. That's why I don't believe it's proper to not let Mr. Socia vote. He's an elected official, and we all have vested interests. We can't use that as an excuse just because his father owns a lease. Thank you very much.
You have something?
Yeah, so I really think you owe Steve Parker, Sue Lyon, an apology for the way you attacked him at the end of the last meeting. They did nothing more than what you asked them to do. And if you were actually going back to the December meeting, when Kelly Fawn questioned you about meeting with Avangrid, and you said that you could meet with everyone you wanted to, in your office or anywhere else, and it really isn't public knowledge what you were going to say.
It was a
other part. Can I finish still?
Yep.
The other part of it is, why weren't they asked? You have a part in your meeting that addresses committee to report. Why weren't they asked to make a report rather than accused of things to start with? And you started with an accusation accusing them. And I think you should have asked them if they had anything to report. The other thing is, you're trying to bring this community together. What you did is nothing more than to drive people farther apart. And I think you owe them a public apology, and you attack them to the paper. Sometimes it's better to keep your mouth shut than just to blow out your 2 cent page. Thank you.
Thank you. Other privilege of the floor?
Right.
Luke?
We were going to give you a presentation of what it would be like to live near some of those turbines. We still have the information if you want it. It was at the project over there in Franklin and Clinton County, and we went past it with our vehicle, turned off the vehicle. It was last Thursday, and we had a decibel meter, we have a cell phone, and we recorded we recorded decibel levels of 55 to 69 decibels. And that was, there was also a additional squeal that came on every few minutes. And we can show it to you, but we'll spare you because we're very happy that the company may be leaving. We're still concerned until the what Met Towers come down and the leases are canceled, because as long as those things, and they're out of the New York Independent System Operators queue, because as long as those things remain, we could be left open to problems from other companies. So we want to thank you for your strength, for your listening, and for all the problems that have gone on. We're sorry for that, but when people's homes are threatened, they have to stand up for it. That's how it's been since 1776. Thank you.
Yes. Kelly.
I would just like to give again my support to John Allen and Steve Hopkins as part of the Wind Advisory Committee. I see this on your agenda for later tonight. This board has already set a precedent of accepting a resignation, or at least, if not formally voting on resignation, but to have resignation there and then reinstating that elected official. You have done that right here on your own town board. So I don't see why it should not happen in this situation as well. So you have two members who are going to serve. President has already been set to have a resignation and then be reinstated, so that should continue to happen here.
Thank you. Other comments?
I just want to thank the board again.
Name?
Pat Walzer. I want to thank the board again for putting our health and safety and our environment ahead of financial interests. And I want to offer my services to the town in thanks as long as the wind companies stay out of town, to help write some grants to bring some money into the town. And I would welcome you, Sue, to let me know if you know of any municipal grants. You know, until I hear from you, I'm going to wait until fall to start searching.
Okay.
And I would welcome everyone else who's been donating thousands of hours of their time to this cause to also consider helping the town get some money for their needs. Thank you.
I would just like to thank the board members that took the time to go through all the information and make an educated decision, regardless of what leaseholders or paid employees from Amherst say. You're going to be rewarded when you go for your position again, and that's going to tell the tale of who's supporting who, because the town of Hopkins was against these turbines. Has nothing to do with any other towns at this point, and I'm pretty sure that that's going to speak volumes when election time comes.
Janice.
Yeah, I want to thank you too, especially Kelly and Sue Wood, for really doing the research, listening to the people who voted for you. And if you drive around, you'll see mainly no wind turbine signs for a reason. These people do not want to be surrounded by turbines. So you've got us this far, we have a good wind law, and now we have to work on zoning. It's a shame we need zoning. It's too bad people can't think of their neighbors before they sign terrible contracts. It's one of those things that we'll have to deal with from here on out, it seems like. Maybe we've made it through this threat, but we haven't. We'll have to wait and see. This is a good sign, and I'm really thankful to be at this point. This is a lot of work from a lot of people who care about this community. Although they might, some of them, not very many, might be over the perishable line. They love Hopkinton. Their families are here. Their friends are here. They are very close to Hopkinton in proximity. To separate our towns is ridiculous. We have the same school. I'm sick of hearing it. I don't want to hear about it again. It's childish. It's a reach. It's unnecessary. We need to bring this community together, because we are raising these children together, and we have an environment that we share. We're in this together for the long haul. Thank you.
Thank you. approve the minutes from May 21st, 2018. Sue made the motion, a second. Kelly seconds, all in favor?
Aye.
Approval of the financial report for May 2018. A motion?
I'll make the motion.
Steve makes the motion, second. Gilbert seconds, all in favor?
Aye.
Audit of the bills, vouchers number 131 to 154, and the general account for $12,168.80. Vouchers number 61 to 72, and the highway account, $11,377.12. Vouchers number 8 to 9 from the VHLS account from May for $1,225. Voucher number 10 from VHLS account, $425 from June. A motion to approve the audit of bills. Sue made the motion, a second. Gilbert seconds, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, nothing under review of budget report to date. Correspondence. There was one thing that Vicki received, I guess I'm going to new business. The only correspondence that we received was the letter from the Auburn's attorney today telling us that they are no longer going to work on the project in Hopkinton. And there was also a letter tonight on the DPS site from Auburn's attorney saying that they are withdrawing from the Article 10 process. Old business. The Wind Advisory Board. We had gone round and round last month as to who to appoint. And so I put it on this month's agenda, but right now I don't think, since Avangrid is pulling out, I don't think there's a big rush on appointing anyone. So what I would like to suggest is that we sit back, take a couple deep breaths for a month or so, and then relook at perhaps just an energy advisory board. That way it would cover wind and solar.
So the motion on the floor carries with three votes.
On what?
The appointment for the wind board.
That didn't.
I can't. He voted. I have to record it. We have a committee and only a judge to turn that motion around.
Wow.
I did not know what the legal ramifications. I knew the motion carried because he voted and I had to record it. I contacted the Association of Towns and their response to me was, the supervisor presides over the meeting in accordance with town board's rules of procedure. Determinations of conflicts of interest are typically addressed locally, so I would refer you to the determination of the town attorney or ethics board regarding whether or not Mr. Sochi had a prohibited conflict of interest that prevented him from voting. As a general legal principle, an action of the town board is presumed valid until such time as it is challenged and invalidated in a judicial proceeding.
Sue did say in the minute that you cannot vote, and according to, I'm following the lawyer, so the association of towns, cannot say vote stands or vote does not stand.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying she could just turn the advice. The attorney cannot tell an elected official he cannot vote. He doesn't have that power.
By him refusing to being, he can't vote because of law.
This is for the board to discuss.
Oh, no. You might want to just take that up with Mr.
I have to say something, I'm sorry, but two meetings ago, you all agreed to Sandy Main.
Four votes for Sandy Main.
So if you're going to go there, you better go back another month.
Yes.
Thank you.
I can see there's more action on this issue.
Yeah, and Avangrid has enlisted as a conflict. So.
going on the advice from the attorney, four attorneys as a matter of fact.
You offered an opinion. You took it upon yourself to tell Gilbert he can't vote, and that paper you have in front of you proves that you were wrong.
Mr. Socia has also been told by Attorney Linden that he could not vote.
Well, get yourself Supreme Court judge.
I read your letter, Gilbert, but I'm not going to do anything.
It's not your decision.
Is that what everybody wants, to take this to court and spend a lot of money on?
Apparently.
I mean, because if that's what we're going to do here.
Well, why is he elected? The people that voted for him.
Excuse me, we're not talking about that. This is the board's decision.
No, because really, on that first vote, we did pass Sandy through. And then it got tabled, and then we took another vote again, and Gilbert voted, and everybody can read it in the minutes, how that went through. I personally think that we should reconsider even having the wind advisory board. It could be a different kind of board, planning board, a zoning board, but the wind advisory board did their job. We have our wind law. So, I mean, my recommendation, just my thought would be that we table this, and, you know, take a while to talk about what kind of board we would want.
But we should have dealt with the wind one then.
No.
The wind board is specifically called out in our law. Specific task that they're attempting to resolve that, we're going to have to deal with the wind one.
Well, that would be easy to revise with whatever planning board we decided would be natural for them.
Well, we should follow up and make sure that.
Follow up with.
How legal it is to tell Gilbert he cannot vote.
But then we would have to go back to the previous vote for Sandy Lane that was in.
If that's what we have to do, we have to do that.
So is everybody saying that they want to take it to court?
And we need to research a little bit. I understand that it's Linden's opinion that he shouldn't vote, but.
It's common sense. It's not an opinion.
It's unethical.
I'm
saying this is the board's discussion, not the public at the moment.
Why is every time Frank speaks, you shush him? Everybody else speaks and you let
him go. I'm shushing them as well too, Rick.
Keep it equal.
So anyway, what do you guys want to do? I just assume go in front of a judge. I don't care. I don't think it's right. He's got a clear conflict of interest.
I want to know.
You're listed on Avangrid, on that site, you're listed from them as a conflict of interest.
Well, for one conflict of interest, you ran that you were against the towers completely. So you've got a conflict of interest.
No, really.
It doesn't work that way.
I'm going to make a motion that we table this whole wind advisory discussion and Gilbert's ability to vote until we can get with our attorney and possibly the judge.
That's going to cost the town, Gilbert.
Do I have a second?
Well, I'm more curious looking too. What is your degree? So you want to take it to court?
We need to get the legal
answer. The only way we're going to get the answer.
Is everybody aware of how much money that will cost the town when we already have a wind law in place?
Do I have a second? We're going to vote, Steve.
What do we have to vote?
We're voting on tabling any discussion on the wind advisory board appointees. And Gilbert can vote as to whether he can vote. And I guess I have to redo that motion because we need to decide if the original motion that supposedly passed last month, we need to look into the legality of that. You still second? All in favor?
Aye.
Gilbert, why
why are you voting on your issue? You can't vote on your issue.
I'd like to see it.
Let's just move on.
And she'll record it as a vote. Who do you represent anyway?
It's Abby.
Vicki, did you and Steve do anything on the local law prohibiting the building of primary residence on Stephen Williams Highway?
Okay, local law, the building.
He said at the last meeting that you two were going to work on it.
Too busy working on Abby.
Okay, yeah. So we'll add it.
Not filing maps.
Meeting nights. Did you review your calendars to see if we could move from Monday nights?
This really is the best evening of the month.
I think it's the best one.
So may I suggest something? Tonight your organizational meeting in January, you set the meetings for the year. They were advertised.
I know that.
Published in the Orange Book that county sent out.
I know that, but it was requested that we look into changing it.
I would just suggest that maybe you address it at your organizational meeting and change that or then.
I know that, but I was just following up on suggestions that I had to make.
Suggestions.
So, Gilbert?
Can you put it in? Been that way for a long time.
Handicap ramp. Sue and Steve, did you get any other quotes?
I called a couple of people and everybody right now is just so busy that they're not really interested in painting and pressure washing the deck. So I don't know if you want me to keep looking or if you just want to go ahead and go with the quote from Glenn.
I think that his quote was a bit much for just.
Does it need to be done right now?
Well, it should be done. It should be done this year, yeah.
Right.
Okay, I'll call.
So once we get more people.
Okay. The insurance report that we got last month. I talked to Steve. He's going to remove the basketball court as soon as they get done paving. And he did say that the highway reports are being done. Did we find out any more about the sign? Okay. Is there a sign going to put in the courtroom for the capacity? Hey, moving along.
Who's responsible for that?
Workplace violence and the sexual harassment training. Steve, you were going, you checked with the fire district to see if we could.
Yeah, I can put us on their online program. And I'll email everybody the links to that so we can get them online.
Okay, and everyone on the payroll has to do that, so. When you get it, let me know so I can email librarian and historian Browns Cooper. Committee reports. Supervisor update. I have nothing. Code. 6 building permits issued, 9 total permits to date, 0 demolition permits, 6 permits down from last year at this time, 0 violations and complaints. 5-4, a permit for a 14 by 18 bedroom addition. 5-11, wastewater treatment system. 5-25, 20 by 30 garage. 5-25, extension of permit number 2015 for an addition to the camp. 5-25, a 38 by 47 foot residence. 5-25, a 30 by 40 garage, guest cottage, and wastewater treatment system. He did inspections on a site inspection on Silver Falls Road, an interim inspection on the Young Road, 2 site inspections on the Young Road. That's code. Assessor. Didn't leave a report?
No
report. Library.
No,
oh, There you go. Library report. Local Battle of the Books was held at the Town Hall on April 28th. About 35 people attended to watch three teams of four to sixth grades compete. The book tacklers from Parrishville won the local battle and went on to finish fourth out of 18 teams at the regional event on May 5th. The participants and their families really enjoyed the program and look forward to competing again next year. The summer reading program will be going on from July 5th until August 1st. This year's theme is Libraries Rock. Stewart Shops is supporting us again with incentive ice cream cones. We will be having crafts, games, and coding activities, as well as story time for young children. On May 2nd, fire extinguishers were inspected, and we will be replacing the upstairs one this summer. Bathroom is clear of supplies and ready for the renovation project the museum is planning. Museum.
Not a whole lot new with the museum. They're also waiting for Dwayne to have a weekend to get the bathroom. Renovation, the gazebo was moved outside, the new sidewalk's being put in. They have the pavers, and they will be putting together a little fundraiser where you can get pavers engraved with names of loved ones. And outside of that, not a whole lot before.
Highway and safety. Paving is done, 2.9 miles on Dave's Mill Road and 0.6 miles on Mill Street. 3,005.21 tons of blacktop at a cost of $150,260.50. Put four new rear tires on truck 6. Put four new rear tires and two front tires on truck 4. Patch potholes, Sylvan Falls, White Hill, Lake Road. Old heating fuel tank at barn has been cut and cleaned as per DEC orders. We'll take to scrap yard this week and send the paperwork in. We'll start shoulder work on the Dave's Mills Road tomorrow. Move the gazebo at Town Park and put stone sidewalk in. We'll finish when time permits. Put four new culverts in Converse Road, 5 left to do. Had 3 trucks to Town of Parrishville 3 days for paving. Started roadside mowing, about half done. Cleaned bridges of sand and cut the brush around them. Serviced the Bobcat. Had 2 trucks in Parrishville 2 days helping repair washouts on Cook Road. Took 9 loads of gravel to Fountain Road for washout. Had 2 trucks at the Town of Lawrence 2 days for paving. He'd like to put the following items up for bids. 2006 Ford F450 cab and chassis with bad engine. 2006 stainless steel airflow sander 1.5 cylinders. A 9-foot Heinecker plow with controls. And an 8-foot truck mount power room. For highway. Town facilities.
Just food pantry was in last week ago Friday.
I'm still waiting for quotes on the shrubberies for the buildings.
Oh, and for the potties and painting off the one.
Rescue, I didn't get a report. I don't know if there's any calls up here this month or not. BHLS Health Center?
We had our meeting and we've got a couple with our ramp and Razor there on board came up and I looked at it and we've got had a person that hasn't shown up yet. So, Steve, if you got anybody that wants to do some work, we got more work down there. Okay. Can't find anybody either.
Next call.
That's it.
Groundskeeper.
Okay, you can see the lawn hasn't been mowed this week. I was gone all weekend. Got into a cable at the town garage, wound it around the blades, and it took more strength than my own air gun to repair the situation, so I had to take a D&D. It'll start being mowed tomorrow. That's it.
New business. Drawings and the bid for the town hall repairs. What did you do with the...
You were in my mailbox.
Well, no, they were just leaning up
against it. I picked them up and put them in my office.
Okay. Kelly and I get her...
Gave her a set. So yeah, I have.
You have yours? The boosters.
They're all the same if you open them up.
I don't get it.
No, well, they were in the mailboxes.
Oh, it wasn't there when I picked mine.
No. So anyway, Steve drew up the drawing, so when we put this out to bid, anyone bidding can come and look at it, see exactly what needs to be done, and I thank him because he did put a lot of work into that. And I just handed out at the beginning of the meeting the solicitation for bids that I'd like to get advertised. If you could just review this, let me know by the end of tomorrow if you see any changes, and then I can get it to Vicki so she can get it advertised so we don't lose that funding.
So motion to forward with that?
What's that?
Motion to forward.
With the bid?
And looking at maybe...
I have a question on that. I was looking at my designs, Steve. Up above, there's a window.
Yeah, we'll have to add that.
Oh. So that would be...
Okay. So, a motion to proceed with putting this out for bid.
I'll make the motion.
Second?
I'll second.
2 seconds. All in favor?
Aye.
Do you want if it's going to be July or...
Bids are due, I have Friday, July 13th, with the bids opened at the regular town board meeting on that Monday night. I gave you a copy of it, right?
No.
So that's that. We got the summer recreation contract in Parrishville. It's for 5 weeks. I need a motion to approve me signing that.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Vicki, appoint deputy clerk.
Yes, so I'm my third deputy. I'd like to appoint Richard Powers.
A motion to accept Richard Powers as the deputy, third deputy clerk.
I'll make that motion.
Steve made the motion, second?
I'll second.
2 seconds, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
They had the rabies clinic at the Tri-Town Arena on June 14th. 196 vaccines were given, $280 donations were received, $135 at the veterinarian, $24 for the syringes, and $121 was divided by the towns of Stockholm, Lawrence, and Hopkinton for $40.33 each. And Vicki, Advanced Business Systems, a copy of quote.
Yeah, the salesman came in and just wanted to give us a quote on a copier. I told him, you know, that I would take it, and the budget this year. But anyways, he gave us a copy on a copier, a quote on a copier, a colored copier, and you can see the quote on it. Gave, it's below state contract price, $5,500. Also, the service contract is quite a bit cheaper than we're paying now. I actually noticed this month that they raised our service contract. It went up to $68.44, it was $59.51. So we're paying $821 a year for a service contract on a copier. This one would be $460.80 a year. And also the per page, if we went over, is only 0.008 per page, and we're going to charge right now 0.023 per page if we go over. And that's only 30,000 copies, and this one is 36,000. I would propose it to the board, and nothing high more than that. Also, there's a proposal here on the cyber security policy from them. It was just an email that they sent me, and it was just when the comptroller comes to do an audit, they're going to be looking for your cyber policy. And right now, we don't have a cyber policy. They will develop one for us. They will also make sure we have all the firewalls we need for our networking. They'll do online backups for us all. We'll have a hard drive here in the office with everything being backed up constantly. I know, I'm sure you've all heard of the ransomware that
some of the towns, bigger towns, but it can happen in size towns. It actually happened in Morris Town a few years ago. It cost them a lot of money to get things up and running again. This would help us to filter out any of those problems, and that's really what's controlling the people. What's your policy? What have you taken steps to protect the town and its finances and stuff like that? So they did give us a quote on what that would cost. I don't know much about it, if there's anybody local that could be able to help you with that. But it's something that you just need to think about, is getting that into place and protecting the computer system better than it is.
So this price is all of these added together?
Yeah, I was a little confused. I told him that we had a board meeting and I would present it, and if there were questions, or possibly he could come and do a presentation to the board in regards to what it would, you know, be and what the cyber policy would be that they would create. Because I'm upset when it comes to.
So this price here, I don't see where it says anything about developing a policy.
No, in his cover letter, it says that they also do cyber policies.
Right.
Yes.
We don't have a price on that.
No. It was just to create the protection for your networking computer system.
I wonder if that's also something you could maybe ask the association to talk about? A lot of times they have.
Something that
maybe we can ask other towns what they have.
Yep. And he did give us, now I don't know if these towns that he gave us are just people that if they have service agreements with their copiers that he's included in that, or if they actually would have worked with them also on this. So that's something that could be asked.
I can give the supervisor from DeKalb a call. Mm-hmm. They look like him a lot.
So there's quite a few.
Quite
a few there that you can see if they just do the copies with them, or you work with them on your backups and your security system.
Most of these are Jefferson County.
Okay. Let's follow that up at next month's meeting. Maybe I'll email him and ask him how much for the cyber security policy for right now. Anything else from the board? Nothing? Okay, so if we have any changes to the bid sheet, get it back to me by end of tomorrow, and I'll send it out to Vicki.
Sue, can I make one comment on your bid?
Yeah.
You've got to be turned in on a day when the town clerk is closed. That makes any
sense. Oh, I forgot you're closed in the summer. Good catch. Do we want to have bids allowed right up until the day of our board meeting?
We've done that, though.
Okay. So Monday, the 16th. Anything else?
Putting the items up for sale.
Oh, I had that written down, too. I had bids.
I'll make a motion that Steve be able to bid those for items.
I'll second. Steve made the motion. Sue seconds. All in favor? Aye. Did I miss anything else? If not, a motion to adjourn.
Who made the motion?
Sue made the motion. Second?
I'll second.
Chief seconds. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.